How did you think about the space of influencer marketing? How has it changed over time? So I worked on an influencer marketing startup in 2010, and that was in the days of Clout and Adly when the space was just first getting started. How has it evolved since then?
Yeah, so in 2010, I was actually an intern. It was my first internship was in 2010, and I was doing influencer marketing. Like, who knew that it would all come back to that? So my job there was reaching out to mommy bloggers, because if you remember, they were like the pinnacle of influencers at that time, were the mommy bloggers. And so my job was just messaging them and contacting them every day, and shipping them products from our PR agency. And that was my first taste of it. It was crazy how much they demanded, how much they even back then they charged. But I think what was interesting is 2010 was like a tipping point when people just started working with brands. Before then, it was almost considered taboo, and some people were like still in that camp where it was like you were selling out if you worked with a brand. So it was just starting to shift during that time. So I was lucky that kind of like I had that experience of like really seeing the full kind of life cycle. Because now, I mean, if you go fast forward to nowadays, it's like, well, it's obvious you're going to get brand partnerships and work with brands. No one's like really looking down upon that. Now I think it's a lot more about authenticity, which is obviously a buzzword that's around influencer marketing all the time. But really, in my opinion, the real future of influencer marketing and where it's heading, and what I had seen at the agency even 4 years ago, 5 years ago, was like smaller real people per se. I like to say like people with influence versus influencers. And that's really what we focus on at Statosphere. But I think that that's where I think you mentioned Clout. That's a good example of they were really trying to show how real people have influence and how they can leverage it. So that's really the niche and space that I got really fascinated by.
Yeah, it's interesting. Someone who has 1,000 followers, but they actually interact more closely and know more of their 1,000 followers, they may have a more pull with their audience than someone who has 1 million followers. Like the percentage engagement rate is exponentially higher.
Yeah, there's studies that show even over 100,000 followers, people under, I believe, 25,000 followers have 4 times the engagement rate of people over 100,000 followers. So if you think about that, if you get a bunch of these smaller, quote, micro influencer or people with real or real people with influence posting, you can move the needle a lot more and get more content in general than some of these larger influencers, celebrity types. I like to say it's kind of like putting all your eggs in one basket instead of like diversifying your assets. But at the same time, it still also has that like, word of mouth feel, a grassroots feel, and really harnessing that. I mean, people have trusted other people's recommendations since the beginning of time. It's like the best way to, actually get your product out there is getting people to talk about it. So creating a systematic way for people to scale that and brands to scale that has been our goal.